Okay.
Yep, that leads back in. Well, you did it, Andrew. You beat the mines.
Oh. There's a hole in the wall.
Yeah.
Excuse me, somebody left a hole in your cave.
We gotta use the shimmy mechanic one more time. Yeah,
you might want to fix that. Also, these boxes are broken. I don't know who broke them. They're bad.
Oh, there you go. You got your healing item. Mind map. When you're done with
it. And another fucking save point?
You're done with the entire mine. Here's a map.
Wait, yeah. Am I done with the mines?
Yeah.
It's fucking...
I don't know why they gave you the map.
This is dumb.
I'm genuinely not entirely sure.
This is dumb.
That's weird.
This is dumb. All right.
Jesus. Look at your ammo. You have almost 700 shots.
I'm gonna make him count.
Fuck that door.
That's called craftsmanship.
Hey, it's a wheelchair. You recognize this room?
Oh, grandma.
You recognize this room?
Yeah. This is the room I first got kidnapped in. Or where Mia got kidnapped in. And then I went after her like an idiot. And then got kidnapped myself.
Hey! Never found that one.
So there was one left over.
Yeah.
In the place. That's what I was right. I said that there... Well, I remember seeing one. So, because I remember I ducked down here
at,
when I saw...
What are you at, like 16 now?
Yeah. Because remember I ducked down here when I saw the dolls. And then I slowly moved around. So I remember seeing it. I was like, I remember there's one in the first house. Okay.
I don't know if I found that one, honestly. Oh, weird. It's not subtitled. They just assume you remember.
I remember.
So look at the photo.
Petridge Farms remembers.
Not that one. The photo on the table.
E00. Yeah.
Yep. They gave us that code at the beginning of the entire game on that photo.
Yeah, so Grandma
Granny.
Is...
Granny.
Oh, it says E001.
Yeah. Granny was Evelyn the entire time. That ladder's broken anyway.
I would have been able to kill her, too, if you just let me do it.
Could you?
I could have shot her in the face hole.
But can she die from that?
Well, no, but, you know, it's
immediately turns into a goop monster and spoils the entire
game. Yeah, it would just startle her. You know, do the Call of Duty thing. Like when you, what's it called?
You can't shoot civilians.
No, when you shoot the captain.
And then it gives you like a sad war quote.
No, but remember in Call of Duty 4, you can shoot Shepard in the training? When you're doing the training, you can shoot Shepard and it does the credits immediately?
I don't remember that.
Oh. Yeah, that's a thing. You can
welcome back.
You can like shoot Shepard when you're doing the training in the first mission. He's standing over there and he's like telling you what to do. You could shoot him and then it just starts rolling credits. I remember game. I played it.
I think they really want to make sure you remember where you are, I guess.
Yep, she's a ghost.
That looks neat. They're also kind of playing around with the idea of like almost letting you see actually what Ethan looks like.
Yeah.
Surprise, he's a some white dude. You're going to research the room?
Yep. I don't want to give her any. I don't want to make her.
This is such an Instagram filter right now.
I don't want to make her think she has priority over my time.
I've used this filter before on something. Back when I thought I could be a Photoshop artist and I was embarrassing.
Photoshop artist.
I would take pictures of stuff and do shitty filters on them for some reason.
Wait, what? Am I still in the memory?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. She just like. What?
Why am I seeing this?
Because we're...
Ethan infected?
Well, yeah, he got infected when he got, like, covered in goop.
Yeah. I mean, he's got to be infected if he's seeing visions, because until now... You'll remember that until now, Ethan's never seen Evelyn, remember?
Yeah.
He's never seen a single vision, but everyone else has. Although, how did the VHS record Mia's vision? Because Mia saw Evelyn? Wait.
What?
I just remembered that you saw Evelyn in the attic.
Yeah.
Her legs.
Yeah, you did see her legs.
That was Ethan. So...
Ethan's been infected the whole time.
Yeah, I guess he's been infected this whole time.
The whole time.
Why didn't you use the cure on yourself, asshole?
Because he didn't know you were infected?
Because he's a stupid.
Well, technically no one knew he was infected.
He's a big old stupid, is what he is. Welcome to the family, son.
I mean, do you not see the fucking arsenal I'm packing?
Yeah, I don't know. Oh. Spooky ghost. He just rumbling into her. Touch me.
That's what I thought. You're not real.
Yeah.
Don't make me unload my fucking arsenal on you.
I mean, you did. You already shot her, and the bullets went through her, and she phased. They made it pretty clear. This Photoshop filter is really, really obnoxious, actually.
Is there? Can I actually not leave? Did I go the wrong way? Are you supposed to go the opposite way?
You can't go this way.
Is that what you're supposed to do? You're supposed to see her with the chainsaw and run the opposite direction?
I don't know if you're supposed to run, but you have to encounter that. I think you have to encounter that. Maybe not.
That's pretty big. Here. So now I'm just kind of...
Let's check out something I never saw.
What?
Go into the VHS room. So I went straight up the stairs. But try the VHS room. There's supposed to be something in here. Oh, look. It's her bed. Ah! I like how he still flinches.
It also shows, like, fake blood. Like,
oh, you see how emptied out this room is so that this would work?
Yeah.
Half the furniture's gone.
I like the moment you ignore her, she just vanishes.
Yeah.
You're just like, I got
time. Oh, the dollhouse is there. In the fireplace.
Yeah.
Also, you can't access the secret exit anymore. It's all blocked off.
The whole house is kind of quivering, though.
Yeah.
Hey, you might want to... Oh, your TV's gone. You might want to get... Wait, is there still the cable for it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's weird. You might want to get your house checked out. It's kind of rumbly. Also, we're still missing that fuse, even though I fixed it before.
You got earthquake termites.
I thought I fixed it before.
Yeah.
All right. Wait. Yep, still has a bag.
Why do you have a bag over your head?
I want to see. Maybe that was actually a picture of Evelyn. Stop. Would you stop? I got time for
shit. She's just walking past it.
Well, I don't... What is she going to do? She's just going to keep chainsawing me, and I don't give a shit. Evelyn.
Uh-oh. That's a problem. You may want to defend yourself. Not like that.
Oh, that's actually hurting me.
Yeah, you should defend yourself or you're going to die.
Hold on, I'm going to...
You should also heal.
Yeah, I'm going to heal up real quick.
Look, a tutorial message.
Thanks.
All right, just got to keep sprinting. You can do it, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it. You have so many bullets, oh my god.
Oh shit, I forgot.
You missed. How? You front fast.
Well... Okay, go. Oh, she did it like really quickly, and I was like, I'm not ready.
Yeah, she poses though.
Nope. Take it, Grandma. What? Are you kidding me? Ethan didn't put that together?
Oh. Yeah, Ethan's dumb.
Jesus.
That's not a fun time. I'm melting. I guess they didn't want to subtitle that part.
She probably said something about how life is pain.
Damn you all to heck. Like she doesn't swear. Oh my god.
Grandma.
Oh no.
Just gonna keep shooting grandma in the face.
Grandma's got parasites. Gonna have to put her down.
Grandma, we gotta put you in a home. By home, I mean bullet home.
Yeah. Bullet storm? Is this as far away as you can be?
No. Yes.
You probably shouldn't hug her if you can avoid it.
Nope. She's just getting close to me.
Oh god. Shoot her a lot until she stops. Ah.
I think she's getting too close.
Oh no. Oh no.
Or the house is just falling apart
now.
Oh no. So it's just a way to make me waste my ammo.
I know how this ends. I've seen Japanese things before. Rolls credits.
What? Now it's just fucking. Oh god, I'm.
I mean, it's already daylight.
Wait, is she just Godzilla now?
Rawr.
She's just literally Godzilla now. Rawr. Okay, well, load the shotgun first.
I'm going. I love the idea of this showing up on somebody on someone's property, and they're like, "Kid, get the shotgun."
Load it. Load the fucking gun, Ethan, like you goddamn
go
fighting a
it.
Monster.
Ow.
You know, sometimes I kind of wish people that would make video games actually took a look at themselves in the mirror and would ask, how would I react to being picked up by this?
I believe in you. Uh-oh. Well, I just wanted a family. Yeah, that's all that happened to this game, Evelyn. You're right. You're very impaled right now. Why don't you switch weapons instead? That's way faster than reloading. Oh my god, he's... Oh my god, she's eating you!
Oh, I just did it too slow. Okay. Well...
I've never seen someone die in that part before! I didn't know you could, I thought it was scripted!
I mean, if there's a way...
Holy shit, she eats you! That's really fucked up!
If there's a way, I'll find it. It's just...
Whoa!
I really wish they pretended, like... I even got the thing to increase loading speed, and there's not, like, a second option for that, you know? Like, you can't get another one that makes your reload speed go faster. So it's like, Ethan, load the fucking shotgun like you actually mean to load the shotgun.
You use two stabilizers.
Yeah. So, like...
I was suggesting just switch to your machine gun. It's faster.
Why, no, but I wanted to use my shotgun.
Yeah, but clearly it wasn't working. And you're like, I am frustrated with how this is not working. So I'm like, here's the solution. I'm going to ignore your solution.
I was frustrated with how slow he reloaded. The shotgun was working. It was doing wonders. It just was reloading very slowly.
I did not know you could die in that part.
Well, now you know.
I genuinely thought that was scripted. I've seen this part so many times.
Since this part's just a waste of ammo.
I'm learning things. Reload. Yeah, right trigger, then square. A little bit of right stick every now and then. For good measure.
She just keeps getting closer as if like this is doing nothing to her.
Yeah. You can die in this part too.
You can?
Yeah. This is the part I have seen people die during.
Well, I guess I didn't.
Yeah. You have to do a certain amount of damage, I believe, or she, like, just kills you.
Oh. Well, I succeeded. Ugh. I like how the fucking government has to show up now, because they're like, hey, yo, there's, like, a giant black monster in the sky.
Yeah.
Someone gonna take care of this?
We got a monster so big it shows up on satellites.
What is her face hole? What is her face hole?
I found her face hole. It's real gross. You never used your mines.
Oh well.
You start whipping them out now.
Wow.
It'd be like the end of Cloverfield.
So you cannot block those. So there's no point in blocking those. Yeah, okay. So there's no point in blocking those. Cool. Yeah, these are things like you should know before going into a boss fight.
I would just say just keep shooting her, basically.
That's what I'm trying at this point. I'm just gonna keep doing that.
It doesn't stand out the same way for me here, but in English, he has a very recognizable death scream, and he very much uses that death scream when you get stabbed in the leg, which for me indicated that you don't even have life right now. Oh, look, a gun.
What?
Grab the gun.
Trying?
Or when you get the chance, at least. There we go, another saying use it. Somebody dropped this gun, apparently. It's the Albert.
The Albert? All right.
The Albert 001. What the fuck is this gun? Look at this shape's so weird.
Playtime's over.
You got a one-liner in. Congratulations. Shoot it a bunch. Oh no, she doesn't like that. Oh no, she really doesn't like that.
I guess this works. New game plus.
That's a complicated looking pistol. Bonk.
That actually does not look good. That like looks really shitty. Really shitty graphics.
That's what they all look like though.
Yeah, but that's like that because it makes it a cinematic scene kind of thing. It looks like PS1 level graphics.
Well, that one went bouncing into the air to highlight how these things weigh nothing.
Yeah. Well, it shouldn't. I mean, they're just.
Yeah, the piece. Well, yeah. They say calcify and Ooh.
Just a memory now?
Wait. Oh, I got a trophy for you getting the ending where Mia's dead.
Oh. There you go.
I was not expecting you to unlock a trophy in this playthrough.
I unlocked two, remember?
I don't remember.
I unlocked another one in the beginning, and we were like, what did we get a trophy for? And we were like, I don't know.
Oh, we never checked, did we?
No. Hey. How's it going, man?
Sup?
It's been a long day. You all good?
Hey, why do you have glow sticks?
Eva Wong?
Eva Wong? He looked away, but it said, I'm Redfield.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
It was Redfield?
Apparently.
Or is it his son?
He looks and sounds and acts nothing like Chris Redfield, but the credits say Chris Redfield.
Oh.
Yeah. I don't know. You got her phone in her purse. You're watching the video of her being like, don't come. Oh, wait, no. It's the babysitting one.
Oh, I was like, are you going to throw your phone out the window?
I thought he was going to.
He's like, I don't need it anymore. Take it, Grandma.
I piss on your memory, Mia.
What? I can't hear you over the not subtitles.
I can't hear you over your PlayStation's fan, honestly.
Thank you.
Don't throw it. It's a fucking phone. Why?
It's her phone.
But they're expensive.
Ethan makes enough money that he doesn't care.
You can take out a SIM card and put in that one. You're littering.
He didn't go to work for like fucking couple. Back to live action.
Yeah, welcome back, live action.
Who says that? Door salesman? Something's off about that.
It looks weird, yeah.
It's like they took a still frame. Like, there was clearly wind going on, but they didn't want that in the shot. Oh, we got picked up by Umbrella Corporation. That's good.
That's weird. People have been making a big deal about the fact that the Umbrella logo is the opposite colors of the actual Umbrella logo, which is like white and red or something, and this one's white, red, and black, and this one's like black and purple or something.
It's blue, I think. But it should be. It should be that way. You gotta rebrand after the fucking 3 zombie apocalypses you let loose in the fucking world.
Apparently changing the color of the logo throws people off. Now, people are wondering what's going on because it's got the inverted Umbrella logo and it's Chris Redfield. So they're like, what?
New Umbrella.
Because Chris, like, vowed to destroy them.
He did. By it's taking
the theme
them
song.
Over. Oh, now you're the new patient. Or you're the new E, whatever.
Well, that was Resident Evil 7, Andrew.
That's it?
You did it.
He just flies away on a helicopter and that's
it? Yep. Alone. Nobody left in his life. After impaling her with a stick and watching her dissolve.
What happened to the son?
He's gone. Also, Marguerite's not confirmed as being dead. Oh, wait, never mind. Marguerite's super dead. She dissolved.
Yeah.
She just wasn't in that vision for some reason. So the sun is a loose end. Maybe he'll be in future games. Maybe he'll be in the DLC.
Future games.
I don't know. They
don't do a Resident Evil 8 in a continuation of this story. Fuck you.
I mean,
stupid.
Not necessarily that, but they reuse characters a lot. Regardless. Like, even if it's not a follow-up of the exact story, characters will show up again.
Yeah.
Like how Sherry Birkin was a playable character in Resident Evil 6, and you save her in 2.
Well, apparently Richard Pelsley is missing. He was on the missing posters.
Poor guy. I hope they found him in hell.
Hey, look, it's a bayou. Thanks.
I'm pointing at the bayou here. Tomohiro Shingu. Holy Bible.
What? What is this stock footage?
Bible gun. Ah.
Get it? It's the Midwest.
I like guns and Bibles and dolls. Why is it printed on his foot like it's clearly not on his foot?
A lot of this looks really out of place because you know that it had to be in different, like it had to be in Japanese.
Yeah.
So they had to like not make it physical text.
Translate the subtitles.
Yeah.
Although all this was always, yeah. Like would it have Japanese subtitles?
It would have,
it would have a Japanese credit in the middle of a clearly English newspaper.
Yeah.
The ideal cookbook. A weirdly nice looking sofa compared to everything around it. Who's Aunt Roby?
I don't know.
Who's gonna tell Aunt Roby what
happened?
I mean,
Yuka-Chi apparently is a pill.
It's a chi pill. They managed to package and sell
this
it.
This is It's actually kind of stupid. This is like really stupid. Like as a credit sequence, I would have just actually preferred a regular credit sequence.
Oh no, they scratched her face out of one newspaper. Now no one will know who she was.
Can you speed it up?
Can you speed it up?
No.
This is going to be a long credit sequence. Well, next game on Sad Games, this was Resident Evil 7. And you liked part of it.
I liked part of it. The ending wasn't actually as good as I thought it was going to be. I think the thing that killed me is that, like, I'm really mad I didn't get to fight Lucas.
Yeah?
I think that is kind of holding me up. Because, like, I wanted to kill
So the way these
everyone.
Credits end is it shows us a screenshot of Chris Redfield, and it says, and it's an advertisement for a free story DLC coming later this year called Not a Hero.
Okay.
So maybe he goes after Lucas. Maybe. So maybe in the free additional chapter, we'll go after Lucas. Or it'll be something completely unattached that explains why Redfield's in an umbrella helicopter, which seems way more likely, honestly. But who knows?
So. I just want to kill everyone in the family.
Yeah, you almost did.
Including
your wife.
Yeah, the only person I didn't get to kill was fucking...
No witnesses.
Yeah, like the only person I didn't get to kill was fucking Lucas. I had so many guns.
But he was an innocent bystander, except for the part where he made saw monster things.
Yeah, innocent bystander who routinely said that he was not infected and playing along, but then trapped a man inside of a fucking weird kill switch escape room thing and then killed him.
Yeah, it's...
So you're clearly just a sociopath that's playing
along?
It's
kind of hard to figure out. Wow, Jack Baker's played by Jack Brand. He almost has the same name as the character you played.
Nailed it. Yep, Chris Weird. Redfield.
Tony Vogel.
David Vogue. Vaughan.
Miguel Corti was a pilot.
Ethan Winters.
Apparently. I remember the pilot.
What?
Minoru Kawaii. David Anderson. Who's David Anderson? Isn't that the name of the character from fucking... Isn't David Anderson the character from Mass Effect?
Yeah.
Did I just read that?
Yeah. Yeah, David Anderson.
That character was named David Anderson, right? That I just read.
Oh, there's a lot of Chinese people who worked on this.
Yeah, they work on everything now.
I thought this was made in Japan.
No, nothing's made in Japan anymore. All of our superhero movies and animation studios are all just Chinese now.
How ironic.
And one of their biggest markets for watching them is also in
yes.
China.
Yes, I was going to say, how ironic dun, dun, dun. That the Chinese are making the thing that they pay us money for later.
But all the stars are in American. I said they're in American.
All in American.
They're all in American.
Is that what
Tony
people...
Vogel, welcome back.
Is that what people...
We missed you from earlier.
Is that what people call fucking Hollywood?
In American.
It's the in American movie studio.
I've seen the game twice now. I still can't tell what's going on with some of the story, honestly. Like, everything about Lucas, like, he's supposedly passing notes or something, and, like, he totally sane and uninfected, but also totally obviously infected and healing stuff back, and a psychopath and lunatic, and...
It also said it was back in, like, 2015, so maybe he got indoctrinated later.
Oh, were the documents from 2015?
Yeah, they were old documents.
Oh, so he could have been infected for, like, the last 2 years.
Yeah.
Okay, that makes more sense.
Yeah, the documents were old. They weren't, like, sent from 2016 or 2017.
Was he even a member of their family?
Yeah.
So why would he be experimenting on his own family?
He wasn't.
He was passing them notes about the experiment, about the infection happening to his own family.
Well, yeah, because they already got, infected.
Yeah.
So he just... I'm assuming he contacted them so he could fix them.
Super weird that he's playing along.
It also seems really weird... That it's really weird that he like when we were getting the arm and the leg, he was like, "What are you doing with this stupid serum bullshit?" I was like, "What?
Don't you want that?"
Yeah, I was like, "Wouldn't you want?"
But I guess he's infected. I don't know.
But like Zoe knew how to make the serum, but he didn't care
about
doing it.
Yeah, Zoe somehow knows how to make the serum.
But he also had, but his lab had the body to make the neo toxin or whatever to kill the girl.
But there's also multiple moments where Ethan seems to just magically intuit how to do things he shouldn't know how to do, almost as if he somehow knows about the stuff too. But that doesn't jive with the fact that he's like, for some reason, like, explained to his friend, like, "Oh wow, Mia's missing, but we found her." But also, why would he know about Mia in the first place? Or Maybe Mia somehow worked with Umbrella. What if Chris works for Umbrella? I mean,
well, Mia might work for Umbrella because
Mia doesn't work for Umbrella because this Umbrella was a third party compared to Mia's group. But what if maybe Ethan already worked for Umbrella?
That would be weird.
That would be weird because we don't know shit about Ethan, so he might secretly have been in, like, on top of all the stuff because he's apparently trained with a gun. That's interesting. But he didn't come with a gun, which is weird.
He didn't even come with a knife.
No,
he came with no tools. He just showed up.
He came
thinking,
in like fucking Miles asshole dead guy from Mount Massive.
Yeah.
He was like, I'm going to walk in with a camera. Oh, no, bad things are happening to me. My hand. All that other stuff. Ethan straight up gets his hand cut off.
Yeah, how did that work?
Like, they stapled it back on and probably splashed some healing juice on it, just like how he put his ankle back on somehow. But then, like, the serum, it's hard to tell what the fuck's going on with that sometimes.
Yeah, there you go. Japanese translation.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, so it just translated to Japanese then. Like, it's confusing because, like, people talk about curing themselves.
Dang, that's a lot of language testers.
People talk about curing themselves, but it seems like Mia can instantaneously kill anybody regardless of any cure.
This game's in Arabic, too?
Yeah, well, it's a lot of languages.
Holy shit.
At the very least, the text.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. The text is in...
Like, it seems like... I think everyone can just blow up anyone she feels like, regardless of infection. But that seems weird that she could do that. Because then how do you even beat her in the first place? If she can just blow up... Like,
well, she didn't blow up us. Like,
yeah,
she couldn't kill us.
The person that charged Mia, she exploded. You remember that? Right before the cutscene triggered, that one guy ran at you and then exploded.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Like, and I was like, what the fuck? But like, you stab Jack with the serum and he immediately disintegrates, which makes sense because I said it doesn't work if you're too far gone. But then you also use it on
Zoe,
but then Zoe just gets killed anyway, the same way that Jack did, but so the serum not work? Or could she just kill anybody regardless of the serum, in which case...
She might have also been too far gone.
Maybe.
Like, she could have been too far gone, but not, like psychotic. Like, she could have been like Lucas, where she's not mentally gone, but
it's
maybe...
It's a weird thing where you spend most of the game trying to get the serum, but the serum accomplishes nothing in the game besides killing Jack.
Yeah. Yeah. It's really weird that the serum even exists. I think the serum only exists so that you can have that moment where you go, like, Mia or Zoe?
Yeah.
That's the only reason it exists.
Which is a bit of a false... Well, it's not a false choice because Mia survives if you cure her.
Well, yeah, but I'm saying, like, it only exists to create that really ridiculous choice that doesn't really impact the ending of the story.
A choice that almost nobody ever makes the way you did.
Does everybody just save Mia?
Everyone saves Mia.
Oh.
Because everyone's like, we came here to save Mia, and clearly every time she attacks us, it's because she's in crazy Hulk mind control mode, which all of them are susceptible to, including Zoe. You've just never been around Zoe. Because she's somehow not been around you this whole time, even though we've seen the layout of the entire place, so we don't know how she keeps avoiding you the entire game.
Yeah, she even has a trailer. So, like, her family is okay with her being there.
Yeah, there's a lot of weird details. So, out of the people that die,
you mean everybody that died?
Two characters get killed by being stabbed by the serum. But then one of them gets killed by... Evie, then two of them get killed by you killing them by hitting them a lot, basically. One of them by in the longest boss fight of the game, the other one because you stab him with a crowbar. But all of them all of them die the same way.
Yeah,
they all for some reason calcify, which is weird.
Even Grandma.
So many logos.
Like
by the
even Grandma calcifies at the end.
Yeah,
like even Evie herself calcifies after you like nail her with a fucking super gun.
Yeah.
You're like, I didn't even use all six shots and she fucking died. I was like, I still got two bullets left.
You used six, there was eight, I think, or nine.
There's
a lot of them.
Yeah.
You actually unlock that gun by beating the game, I think.
Do you really?
Yeah. But I think it might also have its own ammo type, I'm not sure.
I mean, if I could use that through the game, that'd be fantastic.
This game has a lot of weird achievements to encourage you to keep replaying in different styles. Like, one of them is...
Why are you doing this?
Ow, my eyes.
Why would you go back to this?
Because executive producer...
I don't give a
fuck. He's real full of himself, I guess.
Whatever, dude.
No, it's because of this part.
Dolby Louise.
I think it's because they're doing the DLC reveal.
Oh.
Or maybe they're trying to show us something. Look, it's the family. God, you'd have to pause this so much to read all this.
Is it even, like, readable?
Early subjects were destroyed. Yeah, I can read all of it.
No, I'm saying, like, is it even substantial?
You're wondering if, like, whether that's real text or, like, one paragraph copy-pasted?
Yeah.
Which totally happens in movies a lot.
It happens. Well, it has to.
That is your stats.
Stats. Took me 12 hours.
15 Jesus. Restarts. You died 15 times.
Yep. I got 16 bobbleheads, 14 coins. 14
antique coins.
So I'm only missing four.
You missed one file.
Oh, I missed one file. Oh, fuck. My bad.
Four steroids used.
I used four steroids and two stabilizers. Four steroids and one of those things, the vomit, got me to red.
What 115 the fuck? Item boxes.
That's a lot of item boxes, actually. Healing items used, 46.
Woo!
Difficulty, normal.
Normal.
That's a lot.
You got the weapon,
unlocked.
Albert.
I got the Albert.
You got the Albert.
He'll be added to the item box in the main game.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Item, the secrets of defense will be added to the what? Okay.
I don't know what that means.
It's probably another coin or something.
Oh. Rawr, not a hero.
Coming spring of 2017.
Maybe I'll make Andrew play that too. I'm Chris. I have a stubble kind of. My face is weirdly skinny.
It almost looks like kind of too much of an action game. Like it almost.
Yeah, I'm worried that it's going to be like Chris's campaign of Resident Evil 6, which is the worst part.
Yeah, I almost feel like they're kind of like, but we need the action. And it's like somebody's like, just make it
DLC.
We'll
add it later after everyone gives it positive reviews.
Yeah.
Wait for everyone to give positive reviews, then we'll add the shitty part.
I mean, it. I
that
would,
was Resident Evil 7.
It's Resident Evil 7.
What were those achievements?
I don't know.
I want to see.
Let's check.
See how long it takes to sync.
Show me what you've
got.
I
still have stories on here. Oh, right, because you don't use your PS4 for anything but Overwatch. Show us what you've got.
I don't even use it for Overwatch anymore.
Oh, yeah, because you're on PC now.
Yeah.
Do you play Overwatch on this with your friends?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You're not sorting by unlock date?
Yeah, sort by
earn date. Get any
so, yeah,
two.
There's the one.
Take down two or my enemies with one shot? That's what you got?
I guess.
Click on it.
I got it by shooting somebody with a pistol.
Apparently. Where
what?
Where was that?
I don't even know.
Wait.
What the fuck?
Was it bugs? Did you kill two bugs with one bullet?
It might have been.
Yeah, I remember you unlocking that now. That was the one where, like, what the fuck did you get?
Yeah, and then I got, game ending two.
Yeah.
You remember this part?
No,
remember this part of the game?
I love that PlayStation takes a screenshot of every time you unlock an achievement, but it's almost always like a weird freeze frame that has nothing to do with what you did, or it's like a black screen, because a lot of achievements are story-based things that unlock during loading screens.
I like the trophies are just like, oh, you put the heart above the other person. Nah, you just fucking had a broken heart, you put the other person above.
What is the other thing, even?
The person, it's just Zoe.
It's just a silhouette?
Yeah, it's like,
they don't even know how to represent it.
It's like stranger over love.
Yeah, you're a terrible person. How could you?
Okay, whatever. Rare, 16.8% of people?
Look at the percentage of the other one. 31.7. People are twice as likely to save Mia than Zoe.
That's so weird.
Not even counting the percentage of people that got... Whoa, wow. Yeah, it's even less than twice. It's even more rare, actually, than twice as much. Because you got to account for the people that have both. And subtract that from the total.
Oh my god.
And if you subtract that would be an equal percentage for both of them.
Yeah.
So like, for example, if 10% of people have both, then it would be like 21% versus 6%.
Holy shit.
So like, whatever it is, it's even more rare than a 2-to-1.
Why does everyone want to save Mia? Fuck her, she's such a bitch.
Because you literally have no reason to save Zoe over Mia.
Let's see, rarity. What's the rarest one?
Zoe is exactly...
Unlock all trophies. Okay.
Like, Zoe is just somebody who's manipulating you so that she can escape, and she does nothing to directly help you.
Unlock all the coins in Madhouse.
Oh, God.
Fuck that!
So on Madhouse, I think there might be fewer coins, and they're moved around. Yeah. Look at the next one, though.
Complete the game without opening a box more than 3 times?
Yep.
Oh, opening the item box.
Yeah.
Oh my god, your main item?
Yeah. You can't open your stash more than 3 times. And think about how many times you have to open it just to play. One time? Like, this is like the one free bullet from Half-Life 2 Episode 2, where you can only fire one bullet. Where the one bullet, you have to shoot into a lock to even play past that point.
Yeah.
So, you have to open the item box in order to, I think you have to open the item box in order to stash all your stuff in the box to do Lucas's puzzle. Then you have to open the item box again to take everything out after that, so you can do the Jack boss fight. Then you have to open the item box at the end of the game to get all your loot from when you get control over your character again.
Those are the only times you're allowed to use the box?
I don't think there's a chance for you to do it for free. I don't think you ever have a chance to actually use your inventory properly. I think you just, yeah.
What do? You just throw shit away all the time?
So, I don't know. That's some careful planning, and also I think people might cheat. I think you can do that with cheats on, so I think people might turn on infinite, people might unlock infinite ammo or something first. And use like the Albert or something. I don't know. Whatever it is, it's
you're
rare.
You're just like, blap, 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 blap.
It's certainly rare because it's 3%, but also I think Michael from Achievement Hunter maxed out this entire game in a week. So it's not, I don't think it's too tough.
Fuck.
Well, the whole game's only like 4 hours long once you know where you're going. Especially if you're not opening your item box ever.
Yeah, but I'm
look
just
at
like,
that one though. Complete the game using 3 medkits or less.
Well, yeah, you just go on easy though.
You couldn't even get to the bosses that many though.
Yeah, but you could just play on easy.
Yeah.
I mean, some these.
You notice that the antique coins are separated between there's one for easy, normal, and one for madhouse because they I think they move them. So
yeah.
That genuinely is a different accomplishment.
Complete the game on madhouse.
It's hard.
Read all the files in a single playthrough.
That's weirdly hard. What's the one?
I almost got it. I missed one file.
I think I also missed like one. So I'm wondering what the one weird obscure one is that I miss. Although all the collectible ones are really rare. Look at Mr. Everywhere.
Yeah.
It's funny that the fucking files are more rare
complete
than
complete the happy birthday videotape in 5 minutes.
That's not too tough. Once you know how to
do
it.
Yeah, once you know how to do it, I guess.
Yeah, it's
complete
just
complete the game within 4 hours.
It mostly involves replaying the game though. At that point.
Great. Well, I mean, you just go for this at the same time.
Yeah.
Because I mean, at this point, this is easy. You just go on easy mode. You run through the game super quickly.
If I wasn't doing YouTube videos anymore,
you'd probably 100% this.
Yeah, like back the old me that used to not do YouTube videos but did do achievement hunting a lot. Like I would probably 100% this game.
That's crazy.
It kind of has a fun list. Because it's a Metroidvania, so those are fun to run around in and go do all the tasks and stuff. Like that, I know Metroidvania is not
I'm
the
surprised
accurate
I didn't
thing,
get
but
this.
It's got that kind of unfolding thing.
Create all items that contain chem fluid and strong chem fluid. What did I not? Oh, I didn't create the blue shells and the psycho
stem. You never made a neurotoxin or a psycho stem.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those are the only two I didn't make.
Yep.
Fuck.
It's not a hard achievement. It's just there's no reason to make some of those things. The game already gives you more than enough.
Kill an enemy by attaching a remote bomb to them and detonating it? What? You can do that?
So, no, but yes.
Oh, you have to attach it to the crawling ones?
So, what happens is when somebody, you know, when you get grappled and you get launched on the ground and you have to struggle to get out of the grapple when you're on the ground?
Yeah.
If your remote bomb's your current weapon, then your badass move is to attach to them and kick them off and then blow them up. Like the Spartan grab from Dead or Alive. Or you stick a grenade to him. Like that's your way of struggling and getting out of a grapple with a remote bomb is you attach to them. Yeah.
That's really weird.
It's a really specific case. That's a spicy meatball.
Well, then you just hidden trophies?
Yeah.
What the are these probably for like DLC?
No,
because it's separate.
DLC separate.
What the fuck are those hidden ones for?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, we did it. Goodbye, Resident Evil.
I feel like when you beat a game, it should then tell you what the hidden ones are.
Yeah.
All right. Next time on Sad Games.
Someone Sad Games, not Resident Evil unless new stuff comes out.
Yeah.